quantities are represented by a line, and the length of the line represents the magnitude of the vector, and the arrowhead represents the direction. So if AB is a vector, it could be represented, this vector can represent force, this vector can represent velocity, this vector can represent acceleration, displacement, position. All vector quantities are represented in this fashion. The length gives the magnitude, and the arrowhead gives the direction, and symbolically written as vector AB. It can be also represented, if you name it vector A, then it can be also written as a small a and with a arrow over A. Now if 5 newton, suppose force is representing this vector, and the length of this line is suppose 4 centimeter, that means 4 centimeter of a line you are representing by 5 Newton. If you were doing any vector calculation on a paper, you have to write these things. And you have to write the scale also. That means here, if length AB is 4 centimeter, that means 4 centimeter you are representing 5 Newton. And this is the direction of your vector. Obviously, another force you want to represent 10 Newton. So to represent 10 Newton, you have to draw a line 8 centimeter long, because your 4 centimeter is representing 5 Newton. Your representation should be written. That should be hinted. That hint must be given that your 4 centimeter represents 5 Newton. Not necessarily you can take this scale according to your convenience. In this plane, you can represent only force only. In a plane, you are representing these vectors. We are now confined to only two dimensional. Your vector is a three-dimensional thing, and we will learn in advanced stage we will learn three-dimensional vector, but initially we will confine to only two dimension. Clear? So if you want to represent 10 Newton, you have to draw 8 centimeter line. You have to draw a 8 centimeter line. Your 8 centimeter line will represent 10 Newton. This is your 10 Newton, and this is the direction of this vector. This can be written as CD, and your CD is 10 Newton. Clear? And this is the direction of the, your arrowhead gives the direction of your vector. So this way vectors are represented. The length is represented by magnitude, and arrowhead gives the direction. Your friend wants to represent velocities. No problem. Velocity, your friend representing velocities, and he is representing suppose 100 meter per second, 100 meter per second, very fast velocity. And for your friend, he is using a scale. He used only 3 centimeter. Mn. Vector Mn, your frame representing 100 meter per second. So Mn is, length Mn is 100 meter per second, and the direction of your friend's velocity is, and for your friend, 100 meter per second is represented by 3 centimeter line. Obviously, if your friend want to represent 50 meter per second, then he or she has to write, has to draw a vector which is 1.5 centimeter long, KL. For your friend, he is using a scale, and for him 100 meter per second is equal to 3 centimeter. And if he wants to represent 50 meter per second velocity, and the direction of your friend's velocity is in this direction, then he will have to draw only 1.5 centimeter of line. And vector KL is representing 50 meter per second. This way, vectors are represented in different planes, in different papers. In one plane, or if you were doing something related to vector in a page, you must be limited to only one vector quantity. You cannot, in the same plane, it's not possible for you to represent so many vector quantities like force, like velocity, etc., etc. Everything is not done in the same plane, because we draw these vectors to perform some vectorial operations, and vectorial operations like scalar operations confined to only one physical quantities. For example, if we are calculating velocities, then you can draw only velocities. A velocity cannot be added or subtracted with force. Your displacement cannot be added or subtracted with acceleration. So in a plane, you must be limited to only one vectorial quantity. In scalar, we have also seen that this is not a new thing for us. We have never operated volume with mass. If you had added volume, then volume is added with volume. Never we have added volume with mass. Neither we have added mass with scalar quantity energy. So mass is never added with energy. Clear? To perform addition and subtraction, we must be confined to only one vector quantity. Not so many vector quantities are taken. Only one for in a plane, if you are doing calculation of force, then only forces are added or subtracted in a plane. You cannot include velocity here. Or if we are doing a velocity, we are dealing with problems of velocity, then we must confine ourselves to velocity only. With velocity, we cannot add or subtract force. Same rule is followed in scalars also. Clear? So this way we represent vectorial quantities. Their magnitudes are represented by the length of the line, and the arrowhead gives the direction of the vector. When magnitude and direction both are combined, we get a vector quantity. Clear?